For we have heard how the Lord, we heard. Now she didn't have a Bible. She didn't have a Sabbath school quarterly. She didn't have the spirit of prophecy writings. All she did was heard. Amen. She heard and she believed in the God of Israel. She heard. But then later on, when talking to the men, she would say to them, "No, I know." There's a difference. First she heard and believed, but then she said to the men, "No, I know." So she had out of business on the rooftop. And the Bible said, verse 7, "And the men pursued after them the way to Jordan unto the falls, and as soon as they which pursued after them were gone out, they shut the gate. And before they were laid down," verse 8, "she came up unto them upon the roof." And verse 9 says, "And she said unto them, I know." The opportune time. It was the right time that these men came at Rahab's house, because you see, deep within the recesses of her mind, even though outwardly she was, the Bible says she was a harlot, but inwardly, because God looks at the inside, amen? Amen. What you see on the outside don't necessarily show up what that person is. Amen. Even though she lied, God looked beyond that. Because deep down, she was looking for something that had meaning, that was lasting, something that would bring permanent happiness and joy, something that would bring peace of mind and love in the heart and joy to the soul, peace of mind. She was good at what she did, but that brought no lasting happiness. It didn't bring any lasting satisfaction. It was of a temporal existence. And the very nature of some business never satisfies. She needed peace in her life. And they had a good conversation. She had a good conversation with the men. Amen. Somebody will say amen. It's good when you respond, amen. Amen means so be it. Now Rahab is speaking here. "For we have heard how the Lord dried up the waters of the Red Sea for you when he came out of Egypt, and what he did unto the two kings of the Amorites that were on the other side of Jordan, Shin and Og, which he utterly destroyed. And as soon as we had heard these things, our hearts did melt, neither did there remain any more courage in any man because of you." Listen to what she said. This is the harlot speaking here. "For the Lord your God, he is God in heaven, above and in the beneath." This is the harlot speaking. "For the Lord your God, he is God in heaven above,
yes,
and in the beneath. There is no other God like him." No. Have we seen Rahab in a new light? Amen. Now she's a soul winner. Amen. She's a mouthpiece for God. She didn't have a quarterly. She didn't have a Bible. She didn't have the spirit of prophecy writings. She believed what she heard. If your God can do all of this, I want to be a part of that family. Amen. Now she made a bargain with the man. your protection for favor from you. Now, these Israeli soldiers recognized that Joshua was a good leader. Now, they did not know how the city was going to be taken. But they gave a promise in good faith. When we come marching into town, all those who are in this house, amen?
Amen.
Now Rahab was a soul winner for the Lord. Now you read in the book of Matthew about the genealogy of Christ, and Rahab is listed as one of the great-great-great-great-great-grandmother of Jesus, amen? In Hebrews 11, God's Hall of Fame, she is listed by the same name, Rahab the Harlot. Now, if God can use a harlot, if God can use a donkey, amen, I'm sure he can use Brother B. Amen. If my God can cause an axe handle to come up from the belly of a river and cause it to swim on top of the water, is there anything that my God cannot do? There is nothing that God cannot do, amen?
Amen.
The first thing that Rahab did when she let down the men in the basket on that rope, out of a window from the penthouse, she made sure that scarlet, which was red, that ribbon, was in her window.
Amen.
I've tried this in front of man. When the good news comes to us, we need to make sure that our salvation is secure in Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You don't need to know the 28 fundamentals. When the Ethiopian eunuch was studying the book of Isaiah 53 and he didn't understand what he was reading, and the Spirit of God called away Philip and took him to the chariot. And Philip explained to him that is Jesus. And when they were traveling and there was some water in the way, the Ethiopian eunuch said, "What hindered me to be baptized?" And Philip said, "If you believe in your heart that Jesus is who he claims to be." Amen. Baptism follows belief in Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So if you see somebody that is not dressed churchy, or they have an earring in their ears, who are you to judge? They might be a far better person in the eyes of God than you. Man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart. There will be surprises in heaven, friend of mine. What a mighty God we serve, amen?
Amen.
I thank God that there are stories in the Bible like this because it gives me hope. I don't know about you, but Jesus didn't come to call the righteous. He came to call the sinners to repentance. The pimps and the prostitutes, the gray hair, the tongue pierced, they'll be in the kingdom. He was saying to the Pharisees, before you, God loves us, amen? He loves every single one of us. He wants us in, not out. And then she went and she got her mama and her papa. Amen? You don't wait for relatives before you give your heart to Christ. You give your heart to Jesus first. Amen? Then you go find relatives. God will save by families, but as individuals. He will save good families, but as individuals. Amen? Entire families will be saved as individuals. You make your decision for Christ as an individual. When the gospel comes, the good news, you got to decide for Christ. Amen?
Amen.
You got to make sure that your salvation is in Jesus. She called our brothers, verse 13, our father, our mother, my brethren, my sisters, and all that they have, and delivered our lives from them. So they gave her a promise. But if you went out of the house, they said to her, if any were found outside of the house, they were on their own. Amen? When Noah's ark was afloat, after raining for 40 days and 40 nights, that was the seventh ark with the church. Amen? Afloat. So the church... So Rahab's Tommy's place was God's church. Amen. Wherever the name of God is uplifted and glorified. Where two or three are gathered in his name. The Bible says he's there to minister the one thing, and that is to bless. Amen. Amen. To bless. Behold, when we come into the land, thou shalt bind, verse 18, this land of scarlet thread in thy window, which thou didst let us down by, and thou shalt bring thy father and thy mother and thy brethren and all thy father's household home unto thee. Bring them, compel them to come, draw them, woo them, invite them. Said Christ, bring them in. You know the story. Verse 21, and she sent them away, and they departed, and she bound the scarlet line in the window. Rahab, the soul winner for the Lord. Amen. God has a purpose for every single one of us. And he can use us, amen? He wants us in the kingdom. He wants to use us just as he used Rahab. And she is there in God's hall of fame. She is in the family tree that Jesus came. Now the Bible says that she got married. Now, I don't know, the Bible does not say who she got married to. This is just my thought. Maybe she got married to one of those spies. But in her lineage, Jesus came through there. Amen?
It's true.
There is a hole in the family tree. And by the way, friend of mine, that's a Bible word. Amen?
Yeah.
At one time, God says of Israel, you would whoring after other gods. That's a Bible word. Harlot. The word harlot is a Bible word. God does not love the reputation, but he loves the individual. Amen? Yeah. It's like the Sabbath. We don't worship the day. We worship the God who created the day. Amen?
Amen.
So as we face another week, friend of mine, every individual we meet is a candidate for the kingdom, regardless of how they look or what they wear or what they eat or what they drink. They are a potential candidate for the kingdom because Jesus died and he has placed value on every one of his children. Amen?
Amen.
Every single one of us, we are of worth, we are of value, we are precious in the sight of God. We don't belong in the Buddhist, we don't need to be a slave to sin or the devil. Sometimes we gotta change our career. Some of the people who have been of most worth and value to God are people whom we have despised. God looks on the inside. Amen?
Amen.
He loves every one of us. So before probation closes, before it is eternally too late, there are individuals we've got to tell about the love of Jesus. Amen? And she did not keep on living the way she did after that experience. Amen? Because she had found peace of mind. She had found security. She had found a love in her heart and a joy. This joy and peace that the world cannot give and cannot take away. Amen? It's found only in a person. Happiness is not found in things, it's found in a person. And that person, friend of mine, is Jesus. Because he is the Prince of Peace. Amen? What a day of rejoicing is going to be when Jesus comes again. Rahab is going to be in that number, what do you say? Along with 144,000, along with a great multitude which no man can number, as the son of the sea. I know you might be the 144,000. I'll be just grateful to be in that great multitude, what do you say? Amen? Just to get in. But the good news is, whatever qualifies the 144,000 to be in that group is the same qualification that qualified those, all those who will enter the pearly gates.
Amen.
Into the city, amen?
Amen.
And the gates, friend of mine, today is ajar. It's wide open. I read my Bible. Even when the holy city descends from heaven, 12 gates are still open even after the wicked are resurrected. It seems to me that God is still saying, is there anybody who wants to come in? The only time the gate is shut is when the city is surrounded. But the gates are open until that point in time. It says that God is saying in the last minute of your existence, do you still want to come in? The gates were open.
Amen.
Sometimes you say our probation closed when we die. You see, God knows everything, amen? He knows who will be saved and who will be lost. There will be surprises in heaven. Amen. Along with Peter, James, and John, and Daniel, there will be surprises in heaven. Suppose you get up one morning in the kingdom, and your next door neighbor is Adolf Hitler. Did God make a mistake? No, he did not. Amen. Do you know that Hitler was a vegetarian? One of his men explained the story of Daniel to him about the kingdoms. And he shook his hand at God and said, we want to fight our own battles. Who knows? There'll be serial killers in heaven, amen? There'll be pimps and prostitutes in heaven. People are uneducated. Our standard. But all will be saved by the grace of God because of the precious blood of Jesus. We'll make it by His grace. Amen?
Amen.
What a day of rejoicing that will be. I want to be that number when the saints go marching. How about you, friend of mine?
Yes.
Will you be there? If this is your desire, as we sing our closing hymn, I just invite you to stand with me. Hymn number 327, redeem. Redeem means to buy back. Redeem means to purchase. Redeem means to get back that which was gotten by fraud and deception. Redeem, oh, I love to proclaim it. Redeem, brother, by the blood of the Lamb. Let us all stand.
Amen.
Jesus' name, that God's children say, Amen. God bless you.